Good afternoon, baseball fans. Welcome to K13 Media's live coverage of Gordon State College Highlander Baseball, presented by Countryside Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Jackson, Georgia. I'm Chad Feltman, coming to you live this afternoon inside the Advanced Roofing and Interiors broadcast booth right behind home plate on a sun-drenched Thursday afternoon in Barnesville, Georgia. We are getting ready for another great conference matchup between the Highlanders from Gordon State College and the Chargers from Georgia Highlands, who have made the trip down south from Cartersville. Glad to have you here with us on the broadcast as we welcome you inside the Advanced Roofing and Interiors broadcast booth for the very first time today. It's been a while since we've been here for a baseball broadcast, but I tell you what, it is a gorgeous day to have some baseball here today in Barnesville. And the Highlanders, they've been playing pretty doggone good since the last time we had a broadcast. Currently sitting first place in the conference standings, 8-1. In conference play, they currently hold a three-game lead in first over our opponent here today, the Chargers from Georgia Highlands. These same two teams, well, they met 48 hours ago up in Cartersville. And, folks, if you missed the game, you missed a home run derby on Tuesday. 11 total home runs hit in that ball game. The Highlanders went yard 8 times on Tuesday to get the 17-14 victory. If you love offense, that was a game to be at, absolutely no doubt. Will we have that same kind of thing today? Not sure. The wind is absolutely crazy here today at the ballpark, so it may not take much to get one out of the ball field here this afternoon, but we will find out coming up in just a few moments. First pitch today is scheduled for 2 p.m., Highlanders and the Chargers. And as you can see, it is a very, very pretty day for college baseball here in Barnesville, Georgia. Glad to have you here with us on the broadcast. Coming up in just about 90 seconds, we're going to be joined here at the broadcast booth by the head coach of the Highlanders, Coach Tanner Hall. He will be sitting right here to my left. We will recap Tuesday's home run derby in Cartersville and got to break down the first third of conference play. Again, the Highlanders sitting in first place right now, 8-1. Yeah, the conference standings. We'll chat with Coach Hall as we get you closer to first pitch today. It's Gordon State, it's Georgia Highlands, and it's live right here with K13 Media. Ram Truck Month is back at Countryside Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Jackson and Madison, and we're celebrating with the biggest discounts on new Ram trucks that you'll find all year long. We're talking about savings up to $16,000 off the MSRP sticker price. We have the area's largest inventory of new Ram trucks, and we'll beat anybody's price. Have a trade? Bring it to us. At Countryside, we accept all trades, regardless of year, make, or model. It doesn't even matter how much you owe. We'll get you out of your old ride and into a new vehicle today. Shop online, chat with our friendly staff, and apply for easy financing at countrysideautomotive.com. And this month, let's find your new ride at Countryside. I-75, exit 205 in Jackson, and I-20, exit 114 in Madison.
Dedication, compassion, and integrity. We've got the experience and expertise. When you need some help and you feel like there's nowhere to go, you can count on us for everything you need to know. The Fellers Law Firm, where clients become family.
Welcome inside the Advanced Roofing and Interiors broadcast booth live today at Gordon State College in Barnesville. I'm Chad Feltman with K13 Media, bringing you closer to the first pitch scheduled to come up this afternoon around 2 p.m. as Gordon State is back at home to take on the Chargers from Georgia Highlands College. And right now it is time to chat with the head coach of the Gordon State Highlanders. Let me correct myself. The first place Gordon State Highlanders. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Coach Tanner Hall in the broadcast booth with me. Been a while since I've seen you, man. It's good to be back at the ballpark, and that's got to sound pretty good. First place Gordon State Highlanders. Got a good little ring to it.
Yeah, it has been a while, but it's always good to see you. And No, it does. It does sound good, but you know, really, we're only like a third of the way there, so we got a long way to go. So we're looking ahead. So,
well, let's talk about this team we have today. Second meeting this week. You were up at their place on Tuesday, and when I looked at the box score and was getting the recap, I said, "Man, I just missed a home run derby up in Cartersville." Yeah. 17-14, the final. Your team went yard 8 times in that ball game. Take me through it, coach.
Yeah, it was a it was a whirlwind of a ball game. I mean, you know, the wind was howling out up there, turf field, brand new facility. It's beautiful up there. But you held your breath every time the ball went up in the air. Luckily, we were able to hit, 5 more than them. And, you know, we had some runners on when we did so. It was always good to win baseball games. At the end of the day, I don't really care what it looks like as long as we can get that win.
I've always said it doesn't matter if you win 1-0 or 29-28. Win is a win is a win. And, you know, they always say chicks dig the long ball.
They do.
So, you know, there was a lot of them hit the other day. Any chance we see that many hit today, or was that just a fluke kind of a day on Tuesday?
It might be, I don't know, about 11 total, but the number could go, it could be close. You feel it up here. Look, that wind's blowing straight out about 10, 15 miles per hour. I mean, you got stuff flying everywhere around here. So, I wouldn't count it out for sure.
All right, well, we will be prepared for the long ball here today. Let's recap kind of the first third of conference play, because your team right now sitting at 8-1 in the standings. The only loss was a 1-0 loss to South Georgia State, but it has been a heck of a start for your team in conference play.
Yeah. You know, I think it all starts back with our non-conference schedule. You know, we went on the road a lot. We played a lot of good teams. I mean, I think 3-4 of them are nationally ranked. And, you know, we really went out there and we wanted to see what we were made of early. And, you know, I always told them, you know, after wins, losses, whatever it may be, you know, this is going to prepare us for when we get into this conference schedule. And I think it's done just that. We've played really, really well in all three facets, and, you know, I'm really hoping that we can continue to do that.
Got a 3-game cushion right now on top of the standings. Highlanders sitting at 8-1 in the conference standings. Our opponent today, the Chargers from Georgia Highlands, they are sitting at 5-4 in conference play. But overall this year, you look at their overall record, 33-6 this year. This team's a pretty doggone good ball team. Yeah.
No, 100%. And Dash does a really good job with them year in and year out. They're always at the top of the GCAA, and you know, no different this year. I mean, they got a lot of good arms on the mound, got a lot of good bats in the lineup, and they field the ball well. And you know, that's always a good recipe for success.
Talk to me about your team in conference play so far. Is there one particular player, a couple of particular players that have really kind of elevated their game since we started conference play that you can think of?
Two that come to mind. Just looking at it a little bit, Jack Fleming, the right fielder. You know, I thought he had a really, really good non-conference, but he's kind of taking it a tick up. I think he's almost hitting 500 in conference with like 3 home runs, and you know, he's done really well. Another one, shortstop Carlos Martins, and he got off to a slow start and started to pick it up toward the end of non-conference, so we kind of could see this coming a little bit, but I think he's hitting 400 in conference. But I mean, even then, you look at our box scores. I mean, we've scored 17, 17, 17, 15, whatever the numbers are. I mean, we've scored some runs, and so I mean, really 1-9 has done a really good job, and it's been fun too as well, because we can kind of play some matchups with the depth that we have, whether it be lefty bats, righty bats, against, you know, depending on who's throwing. And to be honest, 1-13, 14, whatever that number that's kind of gotten out there in conference, have done really well. And then on the mound, man, Ryan Taylor, the guy who's getting the ball today, has been rock solid. I mean, he's given us, you know, 5 and then 7. Andrew Garnett has been one who, you know, non-conference, I thought he threw the ball all right, but his 2 starts in conference, you know, that now that we've moved him over, have been really, really good. And so, you know, it's been an all-around effort for sure, but there's some guys that definitely stick out.
Let's take a look at one final record before I let Coach Hall get back over to the dugout. That's your home record.
Yeah.
10-1 mm-hmm. here in Barnesville this year, man. What's been the secret? What's the magic about playing at home?
Man, it's just I want to say there's an element of comfort, right? You're practicing on this thing every day. We're out here 2-3 hours every day, and this is home, right? And I think I've told you this probably 2 or 3 times before. If you look back in professional sports, college sports, you know, the teams that go far and make runs, they win baseball games at home, or football games, or soccer games, or basketball, whatever sport it is, man. You really got to be good at home, protect the turf. And, man, we've really kind of made that a focus here, and we've done really well so far.
Well, the Highlanders will try to make it 11-1 at home this afternoon. Again, we've got the Chargers from Georgia Highlands College joining us here today in Barnesville. Coach Hall, good to see you,
yes,
man.
Sir.
It's great to be back at
yes,
the ballpark
great
with
to
you
have
guys
you back.
And the Highlanders, and just a beautiful day. The wind, hopefully, will
take a little break and be easy on us here today.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Oh, man, it is, it's got the capabilities to be one interesting afternoon. Hey, we'll take a quick timeout. When we come back, I've got the starting lineups, and we'll have the first pitch coming up next. It's Gordon State, it's Georgia Highlands, and it's live right here with K13 Media.
Discover the power of precision with Countryside Mower and Gravely in downtown Jackson. During our open house event, enjoy exclusive deals like 0% financing with approved credit on new commercial and residential zero-turn mowers and rebates up to $1,500. We've got the area's largest selection of new Gravely and Aaron's zero-turn mowers. Over 200 in stock and ready for delivery. Need service on your current mower? Now's the perfect time to come see us. We have a huge parts department and we service all brands, not just the brands we sell. Get ready for spring during the open house event at Countryside Mower in downtown Jackson. For more information and to see our full inventory, visit us online at countrysidemower.com.
Welcome back to Gordon State College in Barnesville. We are just about ready to get this one underway here today as Gordon State is taking on the Chargers from Georgia Highlands. The coaches are meeting at home plate right now. Coming up in just a moment, we'll have our national anthem, starting lineups, and the first pitch coming your way live with K13 Media.
Roofing, gutters, siding, painting, concrete, fencing, and more. The list goes on and on. No matter what you need done around the home or office, Advanced Roofing and Interiors can handle it all, even major storm damage. No job too big or too small. When was the last time you checked the condition of your roof? Advanced Roofing and Interiors offers free roof inspections. Don't wait for issues to arise. Contact us today for a free roof inspection. Our expert team will provide an assessment, answer all of your questions, and ensure your peace of mind. Be sure to visit our Facebook page to see recently completed projects and read real customer reviews from real customers. Advanced Roofing and Interiors is locally owned and operated, licensed and insured, and works with all insurance companies. Visit us online at advancedroofingandinteriors.com to learn more and to see all services we offer.
Well, it never fails. You can get here 17 hours early, get set up and ready to go in 30 seconds before the first pitch. Something always wants to malfunction. We're good to go. Glad to have you here with us. It's K13 Media's live coverage of Gordon State College Highlander softball, presented in part by Countryside Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and Jackson. We're live in Barnesville. Ryan Taylor on the mound, getting ready for the first pitch, and here it is. It is a strike delivered at 2:01 p.m., so just about 60 seconds behind to get this one started here today. Glad to have you here with us, says Luke Orphy is in the box. Here's the 0-1. It's low and outside, and that's going to even the count at one ball and one strike. Gorgeous day for baseball in Barnesville. Just underway. Here comes the 1-1 pitch, swing and a miss. Well, like Taylor took a little off of that one. And that's going to bring the count to a ball and two strikes. It'll be Luke Orphy, Grayson Godby, Ryan Weidman. The first three due up here for the Chargers in the top of the first inning. Orphy, a freshman out of Cumming, Georgia, sends this one out toward left center field. It's a long run, and it's going to get all the way off the bottom of the fence. Orphy around first, and he will get in with a stand-up double to start the ball game. Hit it right underneath the 350 mark in left center field. Dalton Bonner chased it as far as he could, but it just did stay in the ballpark. So it's a leadoff double here for the Chargers in the top of the first inning. Oh, boy, is it going to be that kind of day once again? Again, these two teams combined for 11 home runs on Tuesday up in Cartersville. So leadoff runner at second, and here comes Grayson Godby. First pitch on the way to him is a fastball that misses outside for ball one. Grayson Godby, a 6-foot, 195-pound freshman out of North Oconee High School in Bogart, Georgia. He's got a 1-0 count with a runner at second. Good lead out there for Orphy at second. Here comes the 1-0 pitch. Low it outside, and it's ball two. Defensively for the Highlanders, it's Dalton Bonner in left, Daniel Smith in center, Jack Fleming is over in right. Gavin West at third, Carlos Martins at short, Jackson Alford at second, Caleb Huffman is at first, Zach Thompson behind the plate. 2-0 count to Godby, here's the pitch. And that one misses low and inside, it's ball three. So a leadoff double and now a 3-0 count from the Highlander starter, Ryan Taylor. Taylor entering the ballgame with a 3-1 record this year, 4.46 ERA. 3-0 count. Here comes the pitch. There's a strike on the outside corner, and it's 3-1. Again, Highlanders sitting in first place right now, 8-1 in conference play. They've got a three-game lead over their opponent today, the Chargers from Georgia Highlands. They're sitting at 5-4 in conference play. 3-1 count, and here's a stretch in the pitch. Good one, too. It's an off-speed pitch. And it'll run the count full to 3 balls and 2 strikes. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Highlanders 10-1 at home this year. Definitely home field advantage here in Barnesville for Gordon State. As you can hear the wind whipping around behind us. 3-2 count to Godby. Taylor will stay in the stretch. Couple of looks at second, and here comes the payoff pitch. Hit out toward left field. Bonner with a long chase. He'll look at the fence, and it's on top of the hill in left field for a 2-run homer. Well, it did not take long. 11 home runs were hit on Tuesday. That is the first one today. It is a 2-run homer off the bat of the third baseman, Grayson Godby, on a 3-2 pitch. No doubt about that one. Way out of the ballpark in straightaway left field. And that will put the Chargers on the board. Here at the top of the first inning, it's 2-0. That'll clear the bases and bring up the center fielder, Ryan Weidman. First pitch to him, fastball strike, and it's 0-1 on the outside corner. Ryan Weidman wearing number 33 for the Chargers. Out of Walton High School, hometown of Marietta, Georgia, takes the 0-1 outside, and that's going to even the count at 1-1. Gordon State hit 8 home runs on Tuesday. Georgia Highlands hit 3. So far, the Highlands out to an early start here in the top of the first. Here's the pitch, swing and a miss. And another strike on the center fielder, Ryan Weidman. 1-2. Nobody on, nobody out. Top of the first, just underway here at Gordon State College. 1-2 pitch, here it comes. Fouled off at the plate, and we'll do it again. Again, the Highlanders won Tuesday 17-14. Just underway here in the top of the first. Taylor trying to get the first out of the ball game. He'll stay in the stretch. Deep breath, and here comes the pitch. Curveball missed outside, and that's going to even the count at 2-2. Game day temperature right now, we're sitting at 63 degrees. Wind blowing out toward left, not a cloud in the sky. 2-2, here it comes. Grounded over toward short, Martins charges, throws across his body over to first, and it's not in time. A slow roller, Carlos did all he could. He was playing deep in the hole at short, had a charge in, made a good throw over to Huffman at first, but Weidman is going to beat it out for an infield single. So the first three batters here for the Chargers, a double, a homer, and a single. And now to bring up the catcher, Will Coffin. Coffin batting fourth. First pitch on the way is a strike low and outside. Will Coffin, a 6'3", 210-pound sophomore out of Loganville, Georgia. Cleanup batter here for the Chargers in the top of the first inning. One on, nobody out. Ryan Taylor working out of the stretch. Here comes the 0-1. This one grounded over toward third. It's going to get in for a base hit in the left field. Holding at second is going to be Ryan Weidman, but it's the fourth straight hit to start the ballgame for Georgia Highlands. Another single. And just like that, it will draw a visit out of the dugout from head coach Tanner Hall. He would come out and have a word with his starting pitcher, Ryan Taylor. 4 up to the plate, 4 base hits for the Chargers here in the top of inning number 1. We are just underway. Glad to have you here with us from Gordon State College. It is K13 Media's live coverage of Highlander baseball, and today it is being presented in part by our good friends over at Buckner's Family Restaurant in Jackson. They're located at I-75, exit 201 and Highway 36. Open Thursday through Sunday, serving the best fried chicken in all of the United States of America and the best southern food you'll find, all served on Lazy Susan tables. Stop by and visit them this weekend and check them out online at bucknersfamilyrestaurant.com. Taylor will stay in the game. Here comes the DH. This is Davis Newman. Nobody out. Runners at first and second. Top of the first inning. Taylor out of the stretch. First pitch on the way. This one crushed out towards straightaway center. All the way to the fence, and this one's out of here. It's a 3-run homer from Davis Newman. First pitch swinging. Takes it to straightaway center. Daniel Smith could do nothing but look it up and watch it sail out of the ballpark. Second home run of the inning. Here for the Chargers, it's a 3-run shot by the DH, Davis Newman. And just like that, in the blink of an eye, it is 5-0 Chargers. Two home runs in the top of the first, still nobody out. And here comes the first baseman, Barrett Eldridge. First pitch on the way. He'll pop one up here out of play behind home. And there's strike one. Yeah, we need some more baseballs. Umpire is absolutely right. Two of them already knocked out of the ballpark. One to left, one to center. 5-0. Chargers on top. Still nobody out top of the first inning. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Good breaking ball there from Taylor. And he's quickly ahead, 0-2. Barrett Aldridge at the plate here for the Chargers. 6'5", 220-pound sophomore out of Walton High School. There's an 0-2 count to him. Here's the stretch and the pitch. Low and outside. In the dirt, and it's ball one. Well, I was talking with Coach Tanner Hall in the pregame how he thought the long ball would fly here today, and so far, we've got a pretty good taste of it. Two homers in the top of the first for the Chargers. Taylor out of the stretch. The 1-2. Check swing, but it looked like Eldridge was able to pull back, and that's going to even the count at two balls and two strikes. The right fielder, Gray Wilson, in the on-deck circle. 2-2 count to Eldridge. Here comes the pitch from Taylor. Grounded foul down the third base line. 320 down the left field line. 320 down the right field line. It's 385 straightaway center where the American flag is. And 360 in the right center power alley. 350 in left center. 2-2 count. Taylor out of the stretch in the pitch. Went downstairs, but Eldridge wasn't chasing, and the count's full at 3-2. Tough start to the top of the first here for Ryan Taylor. He's got a full count on Barrett Eldridge, trying to get the first out of the ballgame. Here comes the payoff. Just missed outside. Oh, man. Thompson tried to frame it, but did not get the call. And that'll put a runner on first. First walk of the ballgame issued by Taylor. Still nobody out. Top of the first, and here comes the right fielder, Gray Wilson. Wilson wearing number 45 out of Denmark High School, hometown of Alpharetta, Georgia. Good block behind the plate by Thompson. Keeps the runner at first. Wilson is a 6 foot, 190-pound sophomore. One on, nobody out. We are in the top of inning number one. Yes, your scoreboard is correct. It is already 5-0. Two home runs in the inning. Taylor still trying to retire the first batter. Here comes the 1-0. There's a fastball to caught the knees, and it's 1-1. Good spot from Taylor. Nothing to get concerned about here, even with it being 5-0. Again, 17-14 was the final Tuesday. Here comes the pitch. There's another strike on the outside corner. It was a slugfest in Cartersville Tuesday night. And we might be seeing the same thing here again. Just this time we flip-flop the home team and the away team. Here comes the pitch. Outside, and there's ball two. It evens the count, two balls and two strikes. Let's go. 17-14 on Tuesday night. It was Gordon State who scored five in the first inning that night. 2-2 pitch. Here it comes. Fastball. Strike three. Got him looking. And finally, Taylor can take a deep breath. There's the first down in the top of the first. Gray Wilson will go down looking at strike three. First down of the inning, and now to bring up the left fielder, C.J. Blackwell. C.J. Blackwell out of Franklin County in Livonia, Georgia. Bats with one out and a runner on first. This one gets underneath Zach Thompson. That's going to let Eldridge make it from first to second. And it'll put another runner in scoring position. C.J. Blackwell, 6'1", 210-pound sophomore. Livonia, Georgia. They got a pretty good old racetrack up there, too, at Livonia. Old dirt track up there in North Georgia. If you ever had a chance to get up there, it's a pretty cool spot to go watch a race. 1-0 count. We're in the top of the first inning. Runner at second. It's 5-0 Chargers. Blackwell's at the plate. He bats eighth in the lineup. Second baseman Clay Wieson is in the on-deck circle. One down. 1-0 count here to Blackwell. Ryan Taylor working out of the stretch. Wind blowing straight out towards center. A bunt may get out of here today the way this wind is blowing. Here's the 1-0. Popped up out of play, and it's 1-1. First thing I instantly thought when I saw Georgia Highlands come to the ballpark today was the New York Mets. They've got that blue and orange all over their uniforms from top to bottom. They had the pinstripes out for a little bit in BP, kind of looked like the 1980s Mets uniforms. Here's the 1-1. This one hit off the fist over to third. West has it, and he'll squeeze it for the second out. Taylor jams Blackwell. Second out of the inning is Gavin West. We'll move over and make the catch. So here comes Clay Wiesen, second baseman, batting ninth. Runner at second, two outs, top of the first inning. Ryan Taylor trying to get out of this one and get his team up to the plate. He'll work out of the stretch. First pitch is a fastball that missed inside, and it's 1-0. Again, Highlanders 10-1 at home this year. Their only loss was an extra innings loss to Chattanooga State. And that was a game the Highlanders had a chance to walk off in the bottom of the seventh. Here's the 1-0 outside, and there's ball two. Again, the Highlanders sitting at 8-1 in conference play. Yeah, you better hold on to that laptop over there, Kendall. Things getting ready to fly away. Taylor with another look at second. Here's the pitch. Fouled out of play, and there goes the bat. The bat went further than the baseball did over in the on-deck circle. And there's the first strike on Clay Wiesen. Clay Wiesen out of Heritage, Pennsylvania, 5'8", 175-pound sophomore. Going to be playing second base today for the Chargers. Eventually, at some point today, he'll be playing second base. Two down, runner at second. Here comes the pitch from Taylor. This one, line foul down the third baseline. And that's going to bring the count to 2 balls and 2 strikes. One thing's for sure, if you're at the ballpark today, you better have it taped down, you better have it anchored down, or something sitting on top of something on top of something. Otherwise, it's out of here. 2-2 count to Wiesen. Here comes the pitch from Taylor. Strike three call. Got him with a curveball on the outside corner. And finally, the top of the first will come to an end, but not after the Chargers come out with some offensive explosion. 2 home runs in the inning. They put a 5 spot on the scoreboard. We are through a half inning of play. It's Georgia Highlands 5. It's Gordon State coming up.
Hey fans, how would you like to save at your next stop at the pump? Well, thanks to the May and Carter Oil Company, you can. All you have to do is download the new BP Me app today. It's free and it's available for Apple and Android devices. With the new BP Me app, you can save 5 cents per gallon at any BP location across the U.S. Download the new BP Me app today and let the May and Carter Oil Company show you how you can save 5 cents per gallon on your next fill up.
Bottom of the first, it's time for the Highlanders to get some offense going here in Barnesville. Let's tell you how Gordon State will come to the plate this afternoon. Zach Thompson's going to lead it off. The second baseman, Jackson Alford, bats second. Caleb Huffman bats third. Gavin West will bat fourth. Jack Fleming fifth. Carlos Martinez will bat sixth. Casual K will be the DH and bat seventh. Dalton Bonner will bat eighth. And the center fielder, Daniel Smith, will bat ninth. Defensively here today for Georgia Highlands, C.J. Blackwell is in left field. Ryan Whiteman is in center. Gray Wilson is over in right. Grayson Godby at third. Luke Orphy is at shortstop. Clay Wiesen at second. Barrett Eldridge is at first base. Will Coffin is behind the plate. And on the mound pitching today is Michael Sharman, a lefty for the Chargers. We'll get the start today. 6'1", 185-pound sophomore out of Etowah High School, hometown of Woodstock, Georgia. And he's got a 5-0 lead before he ever comes out and throws his first pitch. It doesn't get much better than that if you're a starting pitcher. But again, exact same way the game started Tuesday night. The first team to bat scored 5 runs in the top of the first. That game ended with a final score of 17-14. So this one is a long, long way from being finished this afternoon. Leading it off in Zach Thompson. Zach Thompson, the catcher, batting .344 on the season. First pitch is a fastball, and it's in for strike one. Thompson has played in 33 games this season. He's got 42 hits. Here's the 0-1. This one might be number 43. It's sent out towards straightaway center, but the ballpark's going to hold it. He gave it a good ride, but Ryan Weidman was there to put it away for out number one. So one up, one down for Gordon State. Fly out to center. Thompson just didn't catch the wind on that one. Again, the way it's blowing here today, it is not going to take much, if anything, to get one out of the ballpark as Jackson Alford will step into the box. First pitch is outside for ball one. Jackson batting 377 on the season. 43 hits. He's got three home runs, a triple, and seven doubles. 1-0 catches the outside corner, and there's strike one. Alford with 17 runs batted in this season. Sends this one to straightaway center, and it's going to drop in for a base hit. A line drive to straightaway center field, and it's the first hit of the ball game for the Highlanders. Jackson Alford, the second baseman. He'll pick it up, and now he'll stand at first as Caleb Huffman will come to the plate. First baseman for Gordon State, batting 368 on the year. 46 hits, fouls off the first pitch for strike one. 14 doubles, 8 home runs, 39 RBIs. He has yet to hit a triple so far this season. Lefty on lefty matchup, pickoff attempt over to first, and Jackson's back standing up. We're in the bottom of inning number one. It's 5-0. Georgia Highlands on top. A 3-run homer and a 2-run homer is how they got out to the early lead. Here comes the 0-1 to Huff. It's outside. And it's ball one. Going to even the count at 1-1. Caleb Huffman, the first baseman at the plate. Gavin West, the third baseman on deck. The 1-1 foul tipped into the mitt, and it's 1-2. Again pitching, Michael Sharman. Out of Woodstock, Georgia. Lefty out there for the Chargers in the bottom of the first inning as the wind now shifts directly to right. 1-2 fouled out of play. And that'll keep the count at 1-2. Not a cloud in the sky here today, 63 degrees. And if it wasn't for the wind, it'd be almost a perfect day at the ballpark. But about every 5 minutes or so, we get about 130-mile-an-hour wind gust. 1-2 off the glove of the catcher. Alford is going to be able to get down to second. Ball popped off the mitt of Will Coffin to the backstop. And that's going to even the count at 2-2. That ball was in tight. Just about got a piece of Huffman. But now the count's even at 2-2. RBI opportunity here in the bottom of the first. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hit out toward shallow center field. Who wants it? Weidman will come in, but it's going to be the second baseman, Clay Wieson, making the catch. Tagging for third is Jackson Alford, and he will get in safely with a head first slide. Boy, that ball was not hit deep at all, but Jackson Alford on his horse early, able to get down to third. So the second baseman, Clay Wieson, makes the catch in shallow center for the second out. And now to bring up third baseman, here comes Gavin West, batting 362 on the season. RBI opportunity with a runner at third. First pitch is high and outside, and it's ball one. Gavin West with 34 hits on the year. He's got 10 doubles, 5 home runs, 27 runs batted in. This one fouled back to the fence, and that's going to even the count at 1-1. A good time right here to get RBI number 28. Chip into this lead. Runner at third is Jackson Alford. Two down, bottom of the first. Sharman's ready with the 1-1. Hit off the end of the bat and rolling foul down the first baseline for strike two. A single by Alford to center. He got to second on the wild pitch, and then he tagged on the fly ball from Huffman to get to third. Two strikes here on Gavin West. Trying to get the first run of the game for the Highlanders. Sharman trying to shut him down. The lefty stays in the stretch. Here comes the pitch. Inside, strike three call. Oh, man. Below the knees, low and inside. And there's strike three, and that will end the first inning. A single by Alford is wasted as the Highlanders can't bring him home. We're through one at Gordon State College. It's a 5-0 lead for the Chargers.
When it comes to printing, there's only one name to remember. Georgia Signs and Print. From banners, yard signs, magnets, life-size cutouts, and vinyl, Georgia Signs and Print is the locally owned printer there for all your printing needs. Need graphics for your company vehicles and windows? How about commercial signs and screen print? Georgia Signs and Print can handle it all. Plus, they offer the fastest turnaround time and no minimum order requirement. No job too big, no job too small. If you're looking for a local printer who offers the best customer service, highest quality, and quickest turnaround time, Georgia Signs and Print is your local printer. For more details, visit Georgia Signs and Print on Facebook. At Georgia Signs and Print, we make it our business to showcase your business. Georgia Signs and Print, proud sponsors of the K-13 Media Player of the Game Award.
Coming up after the game this afternoon, we will give out the award for our Georgia Signs and Print Player of the Game. That Highlander player will pick up a free meal to Mama's Kitchen here in Barnesville, located right off of Highway 41, main drag here in Barnesville. Big shout out to Thomas and Angie. Hope they're doing well over there today. We're going to the top of inning number two. It's 5-0. Georgia Highlands on top. This is an exact replay of what happened on Tuesday. The visiting team got 5 in the first. The home team got nothing. Back to the top of the order, it's Luke Orphy. First pitch on the way. Check swing. It's in for a strike, and it's nothing and one. Orphy led the game off with a double off the left center field fence his first time up. Hit it right under that 350 mark in left center. Here's the 0-1. This one fouled off at the plate, and it's nothing and two. He came around and scored on the two-run homer off the bat of Grayson Godby, who stands in the on-deck circle. Chargers hit two home runs in their first at-bat. 0-2 count. Taylor's ready. Here's the pitch. Missed upstairs, and it's 1-2. Highlanders' only loss so far in conference play was a 1-0 loss last weekend against South Georgia State. They're sitting at 8-1 in the conference standings. Got a 3-game lead over second place. Here comes the 1-2. This one jacked down the left field line, but is pulled foul. Out on top of the track in the outfield. It's Highlander team sitting on top of the standings, but team they're playing today, 33-6 overall on the season. Here comes the 1-2. That one missed low and outside, and it's 2-2. And now if you're Taylor, you got to be sitting there thinking, man, what do I throw here? This first five people coming up to plate all reached on a base hit last inning. 2-2 count. Here comes the pitch. This one hit over toward the right side, and it's going to get in for a base hit. Good piece of hitting for Luke Orphy on a 2-2 count. He just punches one over toward right field, and he's got his second base hit of the ballgame. A double, now a single. It's exactly what you want from your leadoff batter. He has been up to the plate twice. He has two base hits. And now to bring up the third baseman, this is Grayson Godby. Two-run homer. His last time up. Runner at first, nobody out. Here comes the pitch from Taylor. It's a hanger, and it's in there for a strike, nothing and one. Check the runner over at first as the wind again out towards straightaway center. And now a pickoff attempt over to first. And Orphy's back safely with a head first slide. Here comes the pitch. Runner goes. And the ball's out of the mitt of Zach Thompson. Stolen base for Orphy. He'll stand at second. Pitch was a ball. Taylor gets the sign from Zach. Here comes the pitch. A little high and tight. And it's taken for ball two. 2-1 count. Grayson Godby at the plate. Ryan Whiteman in the on-deck circle. Orphy is the base runner at second. He led the inning off with a single to right. They're keeping them close as Alfred is back and forth at the bag. Here comes the pitch. Catches the outside corner. Good job by Thompson behind the plate to bring that one in and help out his pitcher get the strike calls. 2-2. Be a big out right here if Taylor can find a way to retire Godby. 2-2 count. Here it comes. Pop foul out of play, and we'll do it again. Godby had a two-run homer. Davis Newman, the DH, had a three-run homer in the top of the first inning. Taylor settled down after that, struck out two of the next three batters he faced. Runner at second, 2-2 count. Here comes the pitch. Swing and a miss. There's strikeout number three. Good fastball from Ryan Taylor. He blows it right by Grayson Godby. First out of the second. And that's strikeout number three for Ryan Taylor. That is the first Charger to go down swinging at strike three. And out brings up the center fielder. Ryan Weidman had a single in the top of the first. One down, runner at second. Here comes the first pitch to Weidman. This one chopped foul down the third baseline for strike one. Ryan Weidman at the plate. Will Cuthin, the catcher, in the on-deck circle. Again, at the top of the first five batters had base hits. A double, a homer, a single, and a homer. One out, runner at second here in the top of the second. Orphy dancing around out there at the bag. Here's the 0-1. This one lifted out toward right center field. It's going to get down and all the way to the fence. It hits the warning track. Orphy will come around. He will score from second. Weidman will hold up at second, and it's going to be an RBI double for the Chargers center fielder. Reached out and just lifted it out to right center field. He's got his second hit of the ball game. And that makes it a 6-0 lead here in the top of the second inning. I mean, just threw his bat out there almost like it was an 0-2 count, and he had a defensive swing. And that ball just carried like it was going to be a simple pop fly, but it got all the way to the warning track in right center. First pitch to Will Cuthin. He'll chop one down the third baseline. Right behind the back of Coach Dash O'Neill, the head coach for the Chargers in his eighth season as head coach at Georgia Highlands. Graduated and played college ball at Columbus State. Played high school ball here in Georgia at Sequoia High School. And now he's in his eighth year leading the Chargers from Georgia Highlands. Got a good ball club this year. They sit at 33-6 overall. 0-1 count, here's the pitch. Good one, it's a strike, it's nothing and two. Taylor went off speed once again, and now he's out front of Will Cuthin. No balls, two strikes, runner at second. That's Ryan Weidman. The DH, Davis Newman in the on-deck circle. Here comes the 0-2. Downstairs, and there's ball one. Taylor came back with the fastball, but it was a little low. And Cuthin wasn't chasing. If you're just joining us on the broadcast, glad to have you here with us. Gordon State College Highlander Baseball with K13 Media live from Barnesville. Here's the 1-2. This one drilled out toward left field. Dalton Bonner is there to make the catch for out number two. Cuthin hit it hard, but he hit it right to Bonner, the former Whitewater Wildcat. And that's going to be the second out of the inning. So two outs, runner at second, and here's the DH, Davis Newman. Three-run homer, his first time up. He's got another RBI opportunity here in the top of the second. Ryan Weidman stands at second base. He had an RBI double. First pitch on the way. It's outside in the dirt for ball one. Not a bad idea there from Taylor. Don't want to serve up anything here to this guy. One-oh count here to Newman, the DH, batting fifth in the lineup. 6'1", 220 pounds. Here's the 1-0 pitch to him. And again, Taylor goes outside, and it's ball two. Newman out of Etowah High School, hometown of Woodstock, Georgia. 6'1", sophomore. 2-0 count, runner at second. We're in the top of the second. It's 6-0 Chargers. Taylor with a look at second. Now he's ready with a 2-0 pitch. Little outside, and there's ball three. Right at the knees, but just a little off the plate. That's 3-0. First baseman Barrett Eldridge stands in the on-deck circle. Wouldn't be surprised if Newman had a green light on a 3-0 if he gets one. Let's find out. Here it comes. He did not. And Taylor pops the corner with a fastball. It's 3-1. Three balls, one strike, two outs. Top of the second inning. Ryan Taylor trying to get out of it. Here's the pitch. This one grounded out towards short. Martinez has it. Throws on the run, plenty of time. And that will do it for the top of the second inning. So a better inning for Taylor and the Highlanders. But the Chargers still get one run in. An RBI double off the bat of Ryan Whiteman makes it 6-0 Georgia Highlands as we go to the bottom of inning number two.
Dodge Power Dollars are back at Countryside Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Jackson and Madison, and we're ready to put some muscle in your garage by offering savings up to $10,000 on our remaining 2023 Dodge Chargers and Dodge Challengers. Scat Packs, Hellcats, Gel Brakes, RTs, and Last Calls. We've got them, but you've got to hurry because once these 2023s are gone, they're gone. Forever. The 2023 Chargers and Challengers are the last Hemi-powered V8s that Dodge will produce. So come grab your piece of American muscle car history before it's too late. Shop online, chat with our friendly staff, and apply for easy financing at countrysideautomotive.com. And this month, let's find your new ride at Countryside. I-75, exit 205 in Jackson, and I-20, exit 114 in Madison.
We head to the bottom of inning number two from Gordon State College in Barnesville. This is K-13 Media's live coverage of Highlander Baseball. Glad to have you here with us today. I'm Chad Feltman with K-13 Media. 6-0 Chargers. It'll be the 5-6-7 spot coming to the plate here for Gordon State. Jack Fleming will lead it off. He'll be followed by Carlos Martinez and the DH, Casual K. First three coming up, and they'll face Michael Sharman. Lefty in his second inning of work. Gave up just one hit in the bottom of the first as Fleming will show bunt and then pulls back for strike one. Second meeting of the week between the two teams. Here's the 0-1 to Fleming. Fouled off at the plate, and that one got a piece of Jack, like down around his left leg. Gordon State won Tuesday night 17-14 in Cartersville. Highlanders hit 8 home runs on Tuesday night. Chargers hit 3. So far, we've got 2 on the board in this one. 0-2 count. Here's the pitch. This one fouled out of play down the first baseline. Both home runs came in the top of the first for Georgia Highlands. A 2-run shot and a 3-run shot. 0-2 count to Fleming. Here's the wind and the pitch. Upstairs, check swing, but ball one. The appeal down to first, and he did not. That was up around the letters. Brings the count to 1-2 to Fleming. Here comes the pitch. That one's high and outside. And the count's even now, 2 balls and 2 strikes to Jack Fleming out of Harrison High School, Kennesaw, Georgia. The 2-2 pitch. This one head out toward right field. And looks like it's going to stay in the ballpark, and it'll be caught in right by Gray Wilson for the first out. Of course, when the Highlanders come to bat each inning, the wind dies. I mean, not doing anything right now in the bottom of the second. Been blowing out to right field since we got here around 11:30 this morning, and Fleming sends one that way, and the wind takes a break. And now it brings up Carlos Martinez with one out, nobody on. First pitch on the way. Fastball a little off the plate, and it's 1-0. Carlos Martinez out of North Cobb Christian. Got a 1-0 count. Here comes the pitch to him. He'll send this one to left. This one is smoked, and it's going to get down for a base hit. Second base hit of the ballgame for the Highlanders. It's a one-out single off the bat of the shortstop, Carlos Martinez. He smoked it out there to left. And for the second straight inning, it's a one-out single for the Highlanders. And here comes the DH, batting seventh in the lineup. It's Casual K. Out of Alpharetta High School, hometown of Stone Mountain, Georgia. Casual K, a 6'3", 215-pound sophomore. Batting in the bottom of the second. 1-0 misses outside, and it's 2-0. Boy, both innings have started the same way. A leadoff fly out to the outfield, then the next man up, a solid single. Martinez is the base runner at first. Here's the 2-0, way low and inside, and it's 3-0. Well, you can't hit a five-run homer. There's no doubt about that, but you can easily chip away. One here, couple of here, trying to get back in this ballgame. 3-0, way off the plate, and it's a four-pitch walk to Casual K. And that's what the Highlanders need, some base runners here in the bottom of the second. So two on, one out, and out brings up the left fielder, Dalton Bonner. First pitch on the way to Dalton. He'll send this one out toward left field, but right at C.J. Blackwell. Barely had a move. Line drive off the bat of Bonner, but second out of the inning. One thing's for sure, the Highlanders are hitting it hard. Eventually, something's got to fall and get down. As we're at the bottom of the order, here's the center fielder, Daniel Smith. Runners on first and second, two outs. Sharman with a long look at second. First pitch on the way. This one skied down the right field line. Foul territory. Note right on top of the chalk. And it's going to be called out there by Gray Wilson. So Bonner and Smith swing at the first pitch they see. That will end the second inning. Highlanders get a couple of runners on, but they are left stranded as we head to the top of the third inning. It remains a 6-0 lead. Chargers on top today, live in Barnesville.
Discover the power of precision with Countryside Mower and Gravely in downtown Jackson. During our open house event, enjoy exclusive deals like 0% financing with approved credit on new commercial and residential zero-turn mowers and rebates up to $1,500. We've got the area's largest selection of new Gravely and Aaron's zero-turn mowers. Over 200 in stock and ready for delivery. Need service on your current mower? Now's the perfect time to come see us. We have a huge parts department and we service all brands, not just the brands we sell. Get ready for spring during the open house event at Countryside Mower in downtown Jackson. For more information and to see our full inventory, visit us online at countrysidemower.com.
We'll go to the top of the third. 6-0 our score. Georgia Highlands on top after they put up five in the top of the first inning on two home runs. They got another one on an RBI double in the top of the second. Glad to have you here with us today. Beautiful day for baseball. If the wind would just cooperate with us. 63 degrees in Barnesville, Georgia. We're about an hour south of Atlanta. Glad to have you here with us again. Highlanders sitting at 8-1 in conference play. They're the first place team, but gonna have to play from behind here today as we're down by six. Highlanders also 10-1 at home this year. Still a long way to go. Top of the third inning. It'll be the 6-7-8 spot in the batting order. The first baseman, Barrett Eldridge. will lead it off as Ryan Taylor is back out on the mound to start the top of the third. First pitch on the way is low and outside for ball one. This was a spot of the batting order that Taylor really had good command of first time through. Eldridge walked, but then the next three, a strikeout, a flyout, and a strikeout. Here's the 1-0. Looked like a slider that missed outside. And it's 2-0. Count, nobody on. Here comes the pitch from Taylor. Fastball that's been a strike the first two innings, and now it's a ball. Boy, Taylor getting squeezed worse than an empty bottle of mustard here in the top of the third inning. 3-0 count. Here's the pitch. This one grounded over to third. Gavin West able to get it. Throw to first is in time. How about the play at third by Gavin West? Long, long range over towards short. He's able to scoop it up, throw on the run. And it's the first out here in the top of the third inning. Good play by West. And it'll bring up the right fielder, Gray Wilson. He struck out looking his first time to the plate in the top of the first inning. First pitch on the way here is outside for ball one. Gray Wilson at the plate, C.J. Blackwell, the left fielder. In the on-deck circle. One out, top of the third inning. Here's the 1-0 from Taylor. That one below the knees, and it's 2-0. You hear the wind picking up once again here in the top of the third as Taylor brings the 2-0. This one chopped foul down to third baseline. These two teams are going to get sick of seeing each other by Saturday night. Could be a lot of runs scored after Saturday night, too. Here comes the pitch. Grounded third base and just foul. Evens the count at 2-2. So after today's game, same two teams will meet for a doubleheader right here on Saturday at 1 o'clock and 4 o'clock. Weather looks great for Saturday, too, if you want to come out and catch some college baseball. 2-2 count. Here comes the pitch. Outside, and it's full at 3-2. Supposed to be sunny and around 66 on Saturday. No rain. Be a good time to come out and check out some great college baseball, the top two teams in the conference. Here's the payoff. This one ripped out toward left, and it's going to get down on one hop in front of Dalton Bonner. And that'll be a one-out single off the bat of Gray Wilson. So Wilson's got his first hit of the ballgame. And it'll bring up the left fielder, C.J. Blackwell. Hit one off his fist and popped up over to Gavin West at third base his first time up. He bats eighth in the lineup. First pitch on the way, low and outside with a fastball, and it's 1-0. You come out and join us here for a Gordon State College baseball game at Gordon State College, free admission. Don't cost you a dime to come out and watch some great baseball. 1-0 chop foul down the third baseline. You can bring a cooler, bring you some snacks, bring a blanket, bring a comfortable chair. Bring the family, the kids, sit right up on the fence. Plenty of room for you out here. Taylor with a long look in. Here comes the pitch. In the dirt, good block by Zach Thompson off his chest protector. Chases it a little bit up the first baseline, and that will keep Wilson down at first. 2-1 count to C.J. Blackwell. We're at the top of the third inning. One on, one out. Taylor with the pitch. Again, missed outside. And there's ball three. That's been where Taylor's missed most of the ball game, that outer half of the plate. But at least he's missing low from the knees down. 3-1 count. Here comes the pitch from Taylor. This one ripped out toward left, and again it's going to one-hop Dalton Bonner for a base hit. Right in front of Dalton. That's the second consecutive hit out to left field. And that's going to put runners on first and second. And the second baseman, Clay Wieson, will step into the box. He's 0-for-1 on the day. Struck out looking in the top of the first. And Coach Tanner Hall will once again come out of the Highlander dugout. And he'll make the slow walk here to the mound. Let's see if he wants to just have a word with Taylor or if that's going to be the end of the day for Ryan. It looks like that is going to do it. So we will have our first pitching change. Top of the third. Ryan Taylor will come out after going 2 1/3. This call to the bullpen being presented by Advanced Roofing and Interiors.
Roofing, gutters, siding, painting, concrete, fencing, and more. The list goes on and on. No matter what you need done around the home or office, Advanced Roofing and Interiors can handle it all, even major storm damage. No job too big or too small. When was the last time you checked the condition of your roof? Advanced Roofing and Interiors offers free roof inspections. Don't wait for issues to arise. Contact us today for a free roof inspection. Our expert team will provide an assessment, answer all of your questions, and ensure your peace of mind. Be sure to visit our Facebook page to see recently completed projects and read real customer reviews from real customers. Advanced Roofing and Interiors is locally owned and operated, licensed and insured, and works with all insurance companies. Visit us online at advancedroofingandinteriors.com to learn more and to see all services we offer.
Dedication, compassion, and integrity. We've got the experience and expertise. When you need some help and you feel like there's nowhere to go, you can count on us for everything you need to know. The Sellers Law Firm, where clients become family.
Pitching change for the Highlanders here in the top of the third inning. That's the end of the day for Ryan Taylor. He'll go 2 1/3 and give way here in the top of inning number 3. New pitcher in the ballgame is number 30, Grant Edwards. 6'3", 210-pound freshman out of Ace Academy in Macon, making his 7th appearance of the season for Gordon State College. Grant Edwards with a 9.72 ERA. One start on the season. 5 appearances out of the bullpen. Make it 6 here. One out, runners on first and second. Bottom of the order is the second baseman, Clay Wieson. He'll come to the plate here. A ground ball will be nice somewhere in the infield. First pitch from Edwards. Here's a fastball upstairs. It's ball 1. Again, Grant Edwards, 6'3", out of Ace Academy in Macon, Georgia. And a jam here for the Highlanders in the top of the third. 1-0 drops in for a strike. And it evens the count at 1-1. Both of those runners on base do belong to Ryan Taylor. 1-1 count to Wieson. Here comes the pitch to him. This one hit out toward left center field. Right off the end of his bat, it's going to fall. Around third comes Gray Wilson. He'll come in and score, and it's going to end up an RBI double for Clay Wieson. Hit it right off the end of this bat, but right out in left center field. And Wieson has his first base hit of the ball game. It's a one-out double. Brings a run in. It makes it 7-0. And now we're back to the top of the order with Luke Orphy, 2-for-2 on the day, a double and a single. Runners at second and third with one out. First pitch on the way. This one smashed to straightaway center. One run will come in. Here comes C.J. Blackwell. He'll score from third. Clay Wieson will hold at third. Third hit of the game for Luke Orphy. His first RBI in the ballgame. Makes it an 8-0 ball game. So, again, both of those runs charged to Ryan Taylor. It'll put runners on the corners. And it's going to bring up Grayson Godby. Godby, the third baseman for the Chargers, had a two-run homer in the first. He struck out in the second. One out here in the top of the third. Chargers have runners on the corners. Runner takes off from first. Orphy's going to get in without a throw as Thompson had a slide to his right and saved that one from getting behind him. So once again, Georgia Highlands with runners at second and third. One out in the top of the third. Grant Edwards pitching in relief here in the top of the third inning with the 1-0 pitch. There's a strike. He was the count at 1-1. Godby at the plate. The center fielder, Ryan Weidman, on deck. Here's the 1-1. This one chopped over to Gavin West at third. He'll come home. Ball's in the dirt off the chest protector of Zach Thompson, and a run's going to come in and score. Clay Wiesen was dead meat on the way home. West one hops the throw to the plate. It hits off of Zach's chest, and another run will come in and score. Makes it a 9-0 ball game. And here comes Ryan Weidman. He's 2-for-2. First pitch on the way. There's a strike on the inside corner. It's 0-1. So far, just one batter now without a hit in the ballgame for the Chargers. 8 out of their 9 starters with at least one hit here in the top of the third. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. Just missed outside, and it's 1-1. Man, good spot there from Grant, but did not get the call. He was the count at 1-1. Runners on first and second, one out. Top of the third inning. Here's Edwards with the pitch. This one misses low and inside. And it's ball two. Ryan Weidman had a single in the first and an RBI double in the second. Again, this team we're playing today, 33-6 on the year. Here's the 2-1. This one fouled right back to the fence. And that's going to even the count at 2-2. But they've struggled a bit in conference play, sitting at 5-4 in the conference standings. But, boy, they've got it together here today in Barnesville. 2-2 pitch, here it comes. Strike three call. Weidman does not like the call. He's got a few words with the home plate umpire, still shaking his head as he's on his way back to the dugout. Second out of the inning, it's the first strikeout for Grant. And it'll bring up the catcher, Will Coulthin, who's 1-for-2 on the day. A single and a fly out to the left. Two down, runners on first and second. First pitch on the way, high and tight for ball one. Again, you can hear that wind in the background really, really picking up here at the top of inning number three. Grant Edwards, the freshman, with the 1-0 count. Here comes the pitch. This one hit out towards shallow right. Going to be a tough play for Fleming. He'll rush in, not going to be able to make it. Runner cuffs him around third to come in and score. Throw to third is not in time. It falls in no man's land. Orphy will come in and score. It's an RBI single off the bat of Will Coffin. It's just been that kind of ball game so far for Gordon State. That ball just fell right in between Fleming and Jackson Alford. Another run is in. It's 10-0 Chargers. Top of the third, two outs, runners on the corners. And we've got a pitch hitter who's come in here. Chopper to third. On the first pitch swinging, Gavin West with the throw to first is in time. And that will retire the side. But the Chargers able to add four more here at the top of the third. It's a 10-0 lead for Georgia Highlands as we get ready to go to the bottom of inning number three. We are live today from Gordon State College in Barnesville.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on now at Countryside Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Jackson and Madison, and we're celebrating with huge savings on all your favorite Jeep models. Right now, save up to $10,000 on new Jeep Grand Cherokees. Take 20% off the MSRP sticker price on remaining 2023 Jeep Gladiators and get ready to go topless with our huge selection of Jeep Wranglers. Have a trade? Bring it to us. At Countryside, we accept all trades, regardless of year, make, or model. It doesn't even matter how much you owe. We'll get you out of your old ride and into a new vehicle today. Shop online, chat with our friendly staff, and apply for easy financing at countrysideautomotive.com. And this month, let's find your new ride at Countryside. I-75, exit 205 in Jackson, and I-20, exit 114 in Madison.
Going to the bottom of the third, 10-0. Georgia Highlands on top of Gordon State. As we welcome you back inside the Advanced Roofing and Interiors broadcast booth, I'm Chad Feltman with K13 Media. Happy to have all of you here on the broadcast with us today, Facebook Live and YouTube Live. We are live at Gordon State College for Highlander Baseball. If you're tuned in today, feel free to drop us a comment. Throughout the broadcast, we get a chance to look through those and interact with you, the viewer, today. So no matter if you're watching on Facebook or YouTube, feel free to let us know. We'd love to chat with you throughout the ballgame. Back to the top of the order here for the Highlanders. In the bottom of inning number three, Zach Thompson will lead it off. First pitch to Zach, drops in for a strike on the outside corner. From Michael Sharman. First time through the lineup, he just gave up two singles. Here's the 0-1 outside, and it's 1-1. One strikeout, two singles, two walks. Here's one inside. First time through the lineup, the Highlanders did not ground out. Five fly ball outs. Here comes the pitch to Thompson. This one ripped down the left field line, but he pulled it foul. One, two, three, four, five flyouts. Definitely keeping it easy out there on Michael Sharman the first time through. Second time up for Zach. He was one of those five flyouts. He flew out to center field his first time to the plate. Leadoff spot for the Highlanders here in the bottom of the third. Full count. Here comes the pitch to Zach. This one, again, grounded foul down the third base line. Count remains 3-2 to the catcher, Zach Thompson. Jackson Alford, the second baseman, stands in the on-deck circle. Nobody out, nobody on, bottom of the third. Sharman's ready with a payoff, and again, fouled off. Good battle here at the plate by Thompson. Again, this was a 17-14 ball game on Tuesday night. Highlanders won that one after they hit eight home runs in Cartersville. 3-2, here comes another payoff. Another pop-up, this time in the infield over towards second, and Clay Wiesen will put it away for the first out here in the bottom of the third. Flyout number six today for Gordon State. Having trouble with the lefty, Michael Sharman. Again, so far, he's just given up two hits. One of those hits came off the bat of the young man at the plate now, Jackson Alford. First pitch on the way. Jackson shows bunt, but he'll pull it back for strike one. Alford batting second in the lineup. Here's the 0-1 to him. It one hops the plate, and it evens the count at one ball and one strike. Again, same two teams back here on Saturday for an afternoon doubleheader, 1 o'clock and 4 o'clock. Weather looks great. Here's the 1-1. It's in the dirt, and now it's 2-1. Highlanders sitting at 8-1 in the conference. They've got a three-game lead over Georgia Highlands, our opponent here today, who sits at 5-4. They're tied with Andrew College. Here's a fastball for a strike. Evens the count at 2-2. ABAC is sitting at 4-4. South Georgia State at 2-6, and East Georgia at 2-7. 2-2 count to Alford. Here comes the pitch. This one hit out toward left field. C.J. Blackwell is out there, and he'll put it away for the second out of the inning. So Alford will fly out to left. Two up, two down for the Highlanders, and here comes the first baseman, Caleb Huffman. Caleb Huffman popped out to the second baseman his first time up. Lefty on lefty matchup. Only left-handed batter in the lineup for the Highlanders. First pitch is a strike, and it's nothing and one. Michael Sharman is dealing for the Chargers. Two down, bottom of the third. The 0-1 ripped out to center field for a base hit. Sharman left that one hanging. And Huffman did not miss. They were playing him to pull, and he took that one closer to the second base side for the third hit of the ballgame. All three hits for the Highlanders have been singles. As now Gavin West will step into the box. He struck out looking his first time up. First pitch swinging, just missed a double down the third baseline. Sound like he hit it right off his fist. Jammed him just a bit, and it's nothing and one. Two outs, bottom of the third. Caleb Huffman stands at first. Michael Sharman pitching here for the Chargers with two down. Here's the 0-1 to West. One hops the plate, gets away from Calton to the backstop. Second wild pitch of the day for Sharman. And that will allow Huffman to get down to second. So another runner in scoring position here for the Highlanders in the bottom of the third. One count to Gavin West. Here's the stretch and the pitch. Inside, off the glove of Coffin, and I think that one actually caught a piece of Gavin. It did. And now the umpires are going to chat about it and confirm the call. Did it hit him in the foot? They will discuss. If it stands, it will put runners on first and second. Well, they will call him back. So the pitch will be a ball, and it should bring the count to 2-1. So Gavin West will grab his bat, come back to home plate. Two balls, one strike, two outs. Bottom of the third. It's a 10-0 lead for Georgia Highlands. Gordon State has a runner in scoring position with Caleb Huffman. He stands out at second. He had a two-out single. And now Coach Hall wants to get a clarification from the home plate umpire. So Gavin West will step back into the box with a 2-1 count. Jack Fleming in the on-deck circle. 2-1. Michael Sharman, the lefty, works out of the stretch. He gets his sign. Quick look to second, and here's the 2-1. It's fouled out of play, and that's going to make it 2-2. Base hit here would be nice to at least get one on the board. Get that goose egg off of it. 2-2 count to Gavin. Sharman looks in. Here comes the pitch. Fouled off at the plate right toward us. That's you, Kendall. Kendall did not even flinch. Our statistician here in the Advanced Roofing and Interiors broadcast booth. I still jump every time. Been doing this 20 years and still think it's coming right at me. Another 2-2. Here it comes to West. This one hit out toward left field. Looks like he got under it just a bit, though. C.J. Blackwell will shift over toward the line, and he'll put it away for the third out. So for the third straight inning, the Highlanders pick up a single, but cannot do anything with the base runner. We are through three innings of play. Georgia Highlands, all over the Gordon State Highlanders. Third of the way through, it's 10-0 Chargers on top.
Hello, friends. This is Pastor Benny Tate of Rock Springs Church. I have one question for you. Are there any dog fans here today? If you love the University of Georgia football, you are in for a special treat. I'd like to personally invite you to Rock Springs Church on Sunday, May the 5th, as I interview Georgia's quarterback, Carson Beck, at all of our services. You can find more information about our campus location and service times online at rockspringsonline.com. I hope to see you Sunday, May the 5th at Rock Springs Church as I interview quarterback Carson Beck of the Georgia Bulldogs. I'll see you then.
Welcome back to Barnesville. It's K13 Media's live coverage of Highlander baseball. I'm Chad Feltman with K13 Media. Glad to have you here with us. We'll go to the top of inning number four. Georgia Highlands on top of this one by a 10-0 lead. And coming to the plate, it's going to be the 6-7-8 spots due up to lead it off for the Chargers. It's going to be Barrett Eldridge, first baseman, leading it off. A walk and a ground out, his first two trips to the plate. And he'll take the first pitch here right off his backside. And he'll take the trip down to first base. So that'll put the leadoff man on. And it's going to bring up Gray Wilson, the right fielder. A strikeout and a single for Gray Wilson. Third time to the plate here in the top of the fourth inning. First pitch on the way to him is a strike on the outside corner. Again, Grant Edwards pitching here in the top of the fourth for the Highlanders. 6'3", 210-pound freshman. 0-1 is tap foul down the third baseline. It's nothing and two. Grant out of Ace Academy in Macon, Georgia. Came in relief last inning after Ryan Taylor went 2 1/3 today. 0-2 count to Gray Wilson. Runner on first. Here comes the pitch. Good pitch there, but Wilson was able to hold off on the bait as Edwards went with an 0-2 fastball up around the letters. Here comes the 1-2 pitch. He went back with it again, and same result. Wilson didn't take. It's 2-2. Wilson batting seventh in the order here for the Chargers. Runner in first, nobody out. Here's the 2-2. Again, missed high, and it's 3-2. Like Edwards tried to go with the curve that time. Started up around the chin and broke down below the letters, just above the belt. Full count. Here comes the payoff. This one driven into right field for a base hit. Jack Fleming will pick it up and get it back in quickly. And that will hold Wilson to a single, but the first two were on base for the Chargers here in the top of the fourth inning. So a runner at first and a runner at second. And here's the left fielder, C.J. Blackwell. A pop out to third base in the first inning. He singled in the top of the third. Two on, nobody out. Top of the fourth inning. First pitch here, swing and a miss. Good pitch there from Edwards. Blackwell was way out in front of that off speed. And it's nothing and one. Edwards staying in the stretch, checks the runner at second. That's Eldridge. Another look, and here comes the 0-1. This one hit out toward deep right. Fleming will chase it all the way back on the warning track. Makes the catch, gets the ball back in, but tagging from second is Barrett Eldridge. So Eldridge will go to third. That's going to put runners on the corners. First out here in the top of the fourth. Again, Eldridge, who's the base runner at third right now, so far, the only batter in the starting nine for the Chargers that does not have a base hit in the ballgame. Bottom of the order here, the second baseman, Clay Wiesen, is at the plate. First pitch on the way. He'll go right field, and he'll send this one out of play over toward the soccer field for strike one. Clay Wieson struck out looking in the first, had an RBI double in the third. Here's the 0-1. He'll send this one over towards second. Softly hit. Alford's got it. He'll go to second for one, and that's all they'll get. Softly hit ball. Jackson Alford goes to Martins. That'll be the second out of the inning, but a run will come in and score. It's going to make it 11-0. And that will allow Wieson to now stand at first with two outs. Top of the order, first pitch is a ball outside to the shortstop, Luke Orphy. 3 for 3 on the day, a double, two singles, and an RBI. Here's the 1-0. This one is in there for a strike. 11-0. Top of the fourth inning, two outs, runner at first. Top of the order here for the Chargers. There's the pitch from Edwards. Another one drops in for a strike on the outside corner. And Grant Edwards ahead in the count, 1-2. Here's the 1-2 pitch from Edwards. This one head out toward right center field. A long run and a diving attempt that will fall on the grass. All the way from first, here comes Wieson to score. And standing at second is Luke Orphy with his fourth hit of the ball game. Just out of the reach of Daniel Smith. Laid out for it in right center, but just couldn't quite come up with it. Second double of the ball game for Orphy. Second RBI of the ball game. It will score Wieson from first. And it makes it a 12-0 game. And here's Grayson Godby, third baseman. Had a two-run homer in the first. Two down runner at second. First pitch on the way to him. There's another good off-speed pitch on the outside corner for strike one. Chargers have scored in every inning of this one today. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. This one hit over towards short. Carlos Martins to his left, and he'll throw to first in time to retire the side. But a few more on the scoreboard. It is a 12-0 lead. Georgia Highlands extends their advantage over Gordon State as we go to the bottom of inning number 4.
Ram Truck Month is back at Countryside Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Jackson and Madison, and we're celebrating with the biggest discounts on new Ram trucks that you'll find all year long. We're talking about savings up to $16,000 off the MSRP sticker price. We have the area's largest inventory of new Ram trucks, and we'll beat anybody's price. Have a trade? Bring it to us. At Countryside, we accept all trades, regardless of year, make, or model. It doesn't even matter how much you owe. We'll get you out of your old ride and into a new vehicle today. Shop online, chat with our friendly staff, and apply for easy financing at countrysideautomotive.com. And this month, let's find your new ride at Countryside. I-75, exit 205 in Jackson, and I-20, exit 114 in Madison.
We're heading to the bottom of the fourth inning. It's a 12-0 lead for Georgia Highlands. They've scored a run in every inning so far today, just scored two more in the top of the fourth. Highlanders needing some runs here to keep this game moving. 5-6-7 spot due up in the lineup. Jack Fleming, Carlos Martins, and Casual K. First three coming to the plate. Just three hits on the day so far for the Highlanders. They've picked up a single in each at bat. That's it. Fleming digs in, first pitch on the way. A check swing over to first. And a good scoop over at the bag by Barrett Eldridge. Got the lucky hop right above the bag at first. And that's the first out here in the bottom of the fourth. And excuse me, check swing, and there's the first baseman. So put it away. Carlos Martins will dig in now. One out, nobody on. First pitch is spiked in front of home plate, and there's ball one. Carlos has one of the three singles today for Gordon State. That came in the bottom of the second inning. Here comes the 1-0 pitch to him. He'll send this one right back through the box. Second base hit of the day for Carlos Martins. He's got two singles. Fourth hit of the ballgame for the Highlanders. Puts a runner on first with one out. And coming to the plate is going to be the DH, Casual K. Casual K walked on four straight pitches. His only time to the box so far. That was back in the bottom of the second. He'll take ball one here. Low one inside. So K has seen five pitches in the ball game. All five have been a ball. Here's the 1-0. There's ball two, low and inside. Dalton Bonner in the on-deck circle. A single in the first by Alford, a single in the second by Martins, a single in the third by Huffman, and now a single in the fourth by Martins. Here's the 2-0 count, high and outside. We just need to let Casual K bat 27 times today because so far he has been the kryptonite to Michael Sharman. Here's a 3-0, and there's a strike on the outside corner. So after seven straight balls thrown to Casual K, there's the first strike he'll see. Sharman's ready with the 3-1. Check swing. Oh! Home plate umpire says he went around. Man. K barely even swung the bat, got called for the strike. Now it's full. Here's the payoff. This one ripped out toward left field. Blackwell will chase it back toward the warning track, and that's going to be the second out. So Casual K gets robbed. Should be standing on first, but instead it's a fly out to left. And it's going to bring up Dalton Bonner, the Gordon State left fielder. Bonner flew out to left in the bottom of the second. First pitch on the way, high and outside. There's ball one. Bottom of the fourth inning, runner on first with two outs. And Sharman will go over and keep Martins close to the bag at first. Nine flyouts in the ballgame for the Highlanders. Here's the pitch. This one down the right field line, but the wind is going to push it out of play. And Dalton Bonner will come back into the box. Just four hits in the ballgame for Gordon State. As we're in the bottom of the fourth inning, they've got a single in each at bat. Carlos Martins leads from first. Sharman's ready with the pitch. This one sent out toward left center, and it's going to get all the way to the fence. Let's see how Martins will get the green light or not. He does. He'll come around third. Throw to the plate is not in time. And it's an RBI double off the bat of Dalton Bonner. First run of the ballgame for Gordon State.
It cannot always be night.
So that will get the Highlanders on the board. Martins scores all the way from first. Makes it a 12-1 ball game as Daniel Smith will dig into the box. He's 0-1 on the day. Fly out to right field. Swings and misses at the first pitch. It's nothing and one. That's a big run out there at second. Trying to get this to within a 10-run ball game. Again, Gordon State needing a chip away. Here comes the 0-1. Another swing and a miss on another good off-speed pitch from Sharman. Daniel was way out in front of that one, and now it's nothing and two. Runner at second is Bonner. Here's the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Sharman threw three straight off-speed pitches. Smith was out in front of all three, and he'll go down swinging. But the Highlanders finally get on the board. An RBI double by Dalton Bonner. will score Carlos Martins. And that will take us to the top of the fifth inning. It's now a 12-1 ball game. Chargers on top.
When it comes to printing, there's only one name to remember. Georgia Signs and Print. From banners, yard signs, magnets, life-size cutouts, and vinyl, Georgia Signs and Print is the locally owned printer there for all your printing needs. Need graphics for your company vehicles and windows? How about commercial signs and screen print? Georgia Signs and Print can handle it all. Plus, they offer the fastest turnaround time and no minimum order requirement. No job too big, no job too small. If you're looking for a local printer who offers the best customer service, highest quality, and quickest turnaround time, Georgia Signs and Print is your local printer. For more details, visit Georgia Signs and Print on Facebook. At Georgia Signs and Print, we make it our business to showcase your business. Georgia Signs and Print, proud sponsors of the K13 Media Player of the Game Award.
We are moving along to the top of inning number five. It's K13 Media's live coverage of Gordon State College Highlander Baseball. Coming to you live today from Gordon State College in Barnesville, Georgia. I'm Chad Feltman. Glad to have you here on the broadcast with us. Rematch from Tuesday night. Gordon State won that one 17-14. It's been all Georgia Highlands today since the very beginning of this one. Chargers got five in the top of the first. They had a couple of home runs to break it open early. They got one in the second, four in the third, two in the fourth. So they have scored every time they've come to bat. Top of the fifth, center fielder Ryan Weidman will lead it off. I beg your pardon. Check the number on the young man at the plate right here. I believe this is the first baseman, Barrett Eldridge. Batting sixth in the lineup. Takes the first pitch, 1-0. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did. There's strike one. Evens the count at 1-1. Nope, it is Weidman at the plate. Thank you very much. There's strike two. So Ryan Weidman. A single, an RBI double, and a strikeout. Top of the fifth inning. This is fourth time to the plate. Here's the pitch from Edwards. Fastball just off the outside corner. Evens the count at 2-2. Nobody on, nobody out. Top of the fifth. Here's the 2-2 from Edwards. Grounded over toward the right side, and it's going to find a hole in for a base hit. Third hit of the ballgame for the center fielder, Ryan Weidman. He goes opposite field, sneaks it in between Alford and Huffman. Another base hit for the Chargers, and here's the catcher, Will Coffin. He's got two hits on the day. A couple of singles and an RBI. First pitch here is grounded foul in front of the Charger dugout down the third baseline. A single in the first, an RBI single in the third. He's 2-for-3. Also had a fly out to left field. Here comes the pitch to him. This one lined to short. Martins with a nice catch. Throw to first is a little off the mark. And just barely getting back is Ryan Weidman. Nice backhanded stab by Carlos Martins. He took a base hit away from Coffin. First down of the inning. Martins with two singles at the plate. Nice defensive play at short for the first out. First pitch swinging here, popped up into center field, and Daniel Smith will make the catch and put away Ryan Martin. Second out of the inning. And here comes Barrett Eldridge. Two down runner at first. Again, the only player in the starting nine today without a hit for the Chargers. He'll bat here in the top of the fifth with two outs. First pitch from Edwards, and that got his jersey. Second time he's been hit by a pitch. That one skimmed the letters right on his chest. Second time he's been to the plate and hit by a pitch. And that's going to put runners on first and second now with two outs. second time Grant Edwards has hit him. And it'll bring up Gray Wilson. Wilson playing right field, 2-for-3 on the day. He's got 2 singles. First pitch in for a strike on the outside corner. Runners on first and second, 2 down, top of inning number 5. Grant Edwards out of the stretch with a peek to second. Here's the 0-1, comes inside, and it's a little tight for ball one. Again, Ryan Taylor got the start for the Highlanders today, went 2 1/3. Grant Edwards came in the top of the third inning. Checks the runner at second once again. Here comes the pitch. It's downstairs for ball two. 5 runs in the first for Georgia Highlands. They have not looked back since. 1 in the second, 4 in the third, 2 in the fourth. Highlanders trying to hold them scoreless here in the top of the fifth inning. Here comes the pitch from Edwards. Pop foul, out of play, and there's strike two. Highlanders just got their first run of the ballgame in their last at bat. An RBI double by Dalton Bonner scored Carlos Martins all the way from first. After Martins picked up his second single of the ballgame. Here's the pitch. Outside. And that's going to run the count full at 3-2. Grant Edwards on the mound. Gray Wilson at the plate. 2 down. Top of the fifth. Runners will be moving on the pitch. Edwards looking for the sign from Zach Thompson. He's got it. Here it comes. Runners go. 3-2. Hit out toward right. Fleming chasing it all the way toward the fence, and he'll make the catch as he backpedals and backs into the fence on the warning track. First time today, the Highlanders hold the Chargers scoreless. They get a single off the bat of Ryan Weidman. Good defensive play at short by Martins. And a nice catch out and right by Fleming. That will keep the game at a 12-1 score as we get ready to go to the bottom of inning number 5. Hey, while we're here today at Gordon State College, perfect time right now to let you know that Gordon State College is looking to hire bus drivers. If you have your CDL and you'd like to come and work for Gordon State College, they are looking to hire. Check out gordonstate.edu. You get all the details. Starting pay of $25 per hour. Just click on the Employment Opportunities tab at gordonstate.edu. I know for a fact bus drivers are desperately needed. Now, of course, we're talking about college bus drivers here, so these young men and these young ladies are very well behaved at Gordon State, and I know the athletic program's desperately looking for some bus drivers. So if you or anybody you know would be interested, again, gordonstate.edu, Employment Opportunities, starting pay of $25 per hour. Bottom of the sixth. It's 12-1 Chargers. And we're going to be back at the top of the order here for the Highlanders. Zach Thompson will lead it off. Zach is 0-for-2 on the day. A fly out to center and a pop out to second. First pitch here is outside for ball one. Michael Sharman continues to pitch for Georgia Highlands. So far, he's given up just 5 hits in the ballgame. As Thompson will take a strike. 4 singles and a double. He gave up 2 hits last inning. Got a 1-1 count. Here comes the pitch. Swing and a miss. Thompson out in front of the off-speed pitch, and it's 1-2. Zach Thompson, Jackson Alford, Caleb Huffman. 1-2-3 coming to the plate here in the inning. Check swing, but looked like Zach was able to pull it back. And the appeal down to first. We'll see he did just that. Got a 2-2 count. Sharman, the lefty, working out of the wind with a long look in. He's got his side. The kick, the 2-2, way high and outside, and it's full. So far today, Michael Sharman has given up just one walk. It came in the bottom of the second on four straight pitches to Casual K. Here's the 3-2. Strike three call. Down goes Thompson. He thought it was ball four, was starting to take off his wristband and threw the bat to the on-deck circle, was getting ready to head to first. But it's a strike three call in the first out of the bottom of the fifth. And here comes Jackson Alford. He's 1-for-2 on the day. First pitch fastball outside. There's ball one. Alford had a single in the bottom of the first inning. Here's the 1-0 to him. This one lifted out towards shallow right field. Gray Wilson barely has to move, and he'll make the catch. So another fly out for the Highlanders for the second out of the inning. That is the 10th fly out here in the ballgame for Gordon State. Two down, and here comes Caleb Huffman. He's 1-for-2 on the day. First pitch on the way, swing and a miss, had a home run cut, but he was behind on the fastball. It's nothing and one. Huffman with a fly out in the second and the first, had a single in the third. Goes that way again and fouls it down the first baseline. Nobody on, two outs. Bottom of inning number five. Caleb Huffman at the plate. 1-for-2 on the day, another lefty-on-lefty matchup. An 0-2 count. Here comes the pitch, and again, he'll go toward the gap in right center. It's going to get down for a base hit. Caleb Huffman with a big turnaround first, but he'll put on the brakes. And back-to-back at-bats, back-to-back singles for Caleb Huffman. He's got two hits on the day. The only problem is all these hits are coming with two outs and nobody on. Runner at first with two down, and here's Gavin West. He's 0-for-2 on the day. First pitch to Gavin. Right back up the middle, and it's going to get into center field for a base hit. Luke Orphy was caught sleeping. The shortstop for the Chargers did not have his feet set. Looked like a statue out at shortstop. Froze him. First pitch swinging. Gavin West catches him by surprise. It's back-to-back hits, and here comes Jack Fleming. Fleming swings at the first pitch and chops it down the third baseline for strike one. Jack's looking for his first hit of the ballgame. Fly out to right field in the second, and a check swing ground out to first in the bottom of the fourth. Here's the 0-1. This one ripped out towards straightaway center, but again, barely having to move is the center fielder, Ryan Whiteman, and he'll put it away for out number three. Highlanders get a couple of singles off the bat of Caleb Huffman and Gavin West. But again, left stranded. We are through five in Barnesville. It remains a 12-1 lead. Georgia Highlands on top of Gordon State College.
Roofing, gutters, siding, painting, concrete, fencing, and more. The list goes on and on. No matter what you need done around the home or office, Advanced Roofing and Interiors can handle it all, even major storm damage. No job too big or too small. When was the last time you checked the condition of your roof? Advanced Roofing and Interiors offers free roof inspections. Don't wait for issues to arise. Contact us today for a free roof inspection. Our expert team will provide an assessment, answer all of your questions, and ensure your peace of mind. Be sure to visit our Facebook page to see recently completed projects and read real customer reviews from real customers. Advanced Roofing and Interiors is locally owned and operated, licensed and insured, and works with all insurance companies. Visit us online at advancedroofingandinteriors.com to learn more and to see all services we offer.
Top of the sixth inning, it's a 12-1 lead for the Chargers. They have pounded out 15 hits so far in the ballgame. 12 runs on 15 hits, but the Highlanders kept them scoreless last inning. Grant Edwards back out to pitch here in the top of the sixth. First pitch swinging, it may not be a scoreless sixth. There's a long drive. My goodness, it's over the scoreboard in left center field. C.J. Blackwell has just hit the third home run of the ball game for the Chargers. First pitch swinging over the scoreboard in left center field to make it a 13-1 ball game. Goodness gracious, what a shot by Blackwell. Yes, indeed. Boom is right. 13-1 Chargers, and here's the second baseman, Clay Wiesen. First pitch on the way. He tried to do the same thing, but lifts it out of play behind home plate for strike one. Clay Wiesen today, a strikeout in the top of the first, an RBI double in the third, and picked up an RBI on a ground out to second in the fourth. Here's the 0-1. A check swing, but Wiesen was able to hold it back, and that evens the count at one ball and one strike. Third homer of the day for the Chargers. They hit three in the game against Gordon State on Tuesday. Here's the 1-1 in the dirt outside, and it's 2-1. Only problem with that is we hit eight on Tuesday. But so far today, just not finding the offense. Maybe some late inning magic. Here's the 2-1. This one grounded, high chopper to third. Gavin West comes in, edge of the grass, throw to first is in time. And that's going to be the first out in the top of the sixth. So Wiesen will ground out. And we'll go back to the top of the order. Coming to the plate, the shortstop, Luke Orphy. 4-for-4 on the day. Two doubles, two singles, two RBIs. He'll bat with nobody on, one out in the top of the sixth. First pitch swinging. It's nothing and one. Good pitch there from Edwards. May have taken a little off of that one to keep Orphy off balanced. Here comes the 0-1 from Edwards. It's foul tipped into the mitt, and there's strike two. Small victories at this point in the ballgame. Just trying to retire the guys. 4-for-4. Here comes the 0-2 from Grant. This one smashed down the left field line, and it's out of play. Orphy turned on that one and just about knocked the cover off the baseball. Nobody on, one out, top of inning number six. A solo homer by Blackwell. This one hit over towards second. Good backhanded stop by Jackson Alford, and the Highlanders will, for the first time today, finally retire Luke Orphy. Second out of the inning. Two down, nobody on, and here comes the third baseman, Grayson Godby. Godby 1-for-4 on the day. That one was a big shot, though, in the top of the first. It was a two-run home run. That got the Chargers on the board. First pitch here in the sixth is taken for a strike outside. 16 hits in the ballgame for the Chargers as we're in the top of the sixth inning. Here's the 0-1. That one hops the plate, evens the count at 1-1. You know, it's not very often you say you can score 14 runs in a ball game and lost, but that's what happened on Tuesday night, and Chargers taking it out on the Highlanders here today. Here's the 1-1. This one smashed down the left field line. Bonner will watch it sail out of the ballpark. On top of the hill, left field is the fourth home run of the ball game for the Chargers. Second homer of the day for Grayson Godby. It's a solo shot. His second homer of the day, his third RBI of the ball game. And that makes it 14-1 Chargers. And here comes the center fielder, Ryan Weidman. He's got three hits in the game. First pitch on the way. Roped it foul down the third baseline for strike one. A single, an RBI double, and a single. Struck out looking in the top of the third. Grant Edwards on the mound with two down. Here's the 0-1. This one lifted out toward right center. Daniel Smith will shade over toward right, and he'll make the catch out in the gap for the second out. But two more come across. A couple of solo home runs. One by Grayson Godby. One by C.J. Blackwell. Chargers put two more on the board as we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. They extend their lead 14-1 over Gordon State College.
Discover the power of precision with Countryside Mower and Gravely in downtown Jackson. During our open house event, enjoy exclusive deals like 0% financing with approved credit on new commercial and residential zero-turn mowers and rebates up to $1,500. We've got the area's largest selection of new Gravely and Aaron's zero-turn mowers. Over 200 in stock and ready for delivery. Need service on your current mower? Now's the perfect time to come see us. We have a huge parts department and we service all brands, not just the brands we sell. Get ready for spring during the open house event at Countryside Mower in downtown Jackson. For more information and to see our full inventory, visit us online at countrysidemower.com.
Today's coverage of Highlander Baseball is being presented in part by Buckner's Family Restaurant in Jackson. They're located right off of I-75, exit 201 at Highway 36. Buckner's Family Restaurant serving up the best fried chicken in all of America and the best sides to go with it. Best Southern-style cooking you'll find anywhere in the area. Be sure to check them out Thursday through Sunday. Come join your friends around their famous Lazy Susan tables for a great Southern meal. For more information, visit buttonsfamilyrestaurant.com. Oh, and don't forget about the ribs on Friday nights after 4 o'clock. Bottom of the sixth. First pitch swinging is Martins. He will send it down the third baseline. Throw to first is just barely in time. Good play from deep at third by Grayson Godby. And a good stretch by Barrett Eldridge at first to retire Martins by the blink of an eye for the first out. So one down and nobody on base. First pitch is outside for ball one to Casual K. A walk in the second, a flyout in the fourth. And it's 2-0. Nobody on, one out. Michael Sharman continues to deal here for the Chargers in the sixth. 2-0, grounded to third. Another opportunity at third. Throw to first is in time again by Godby. Had to keep his glove on the dirt. He's able to pick it up and throw to first in time and has back-to-back groundouts to third base for the Highlanders here in the bottom of the sixth. And that'll bring up Dalton Bonner. An RBI double in his last at-bat. Scored Carlos Martins from first base. That's been the only run of the ballgame so far for the Highlanders. He'll take ball one. Dalton Bonner playing left field here for the Highlanders. Bottom of the sixth inning. Here's the 1-0. There's a delayed strike call to even the count at 1-1. Bonner out of Whitewater High School, South Fayette County, former Wolverine. Here's the 1-1 to him. Slow chopper foul down the third baseline. Good baseball program over there at Whitewater. Had a chance to go broadcast a game earlier this year with Coach Crumley when Pike County came to town early in the season. Bonner's behind. He's got two strikes, 1-2 count. Here's the wind and the pitch. Fastball just missed. Not by much. That's the first close call the Highlanders have gotten to go their way all day. Here's the 2-2. This one popped up, foul territory, tore the dugout, and gonna be caught by the first baseman, Barrett Aldridge. Makes a basket catch in front of the Highlanders dugout. And that will retire the side for Gordon State here in the bottom of the sixth. It's a 1-2-3. Bottom of inning number six. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. We'll go to the top of inning number seven. It remains a 14-1 lead. Chargers on top of Gordon State live today from Barnesville.
Hello, friends. This is Pastor Benny Tate of Rock Springs Church. I have one question for you. Are there any dog fans here today? If you love the University of Georgia football, you are in for a special treat. I'd like to personally invite you to Rock Springs Church on Sunday, May the 5th, as I interview Georgia's quarterback, Carson Beck, at all of our services. You can find more information about our campus location and service times online at rockspringsonline.com. I hope to see you Sunday, May the 5th at Rock Springs Church as I interview quarterback Carson Beck of the Georgia Bulldogs. I'll see you then.
Man, it's going to be a fun event at Rock Springs Church with UGA quarterback Carson Beck coming to town in May. We're going to the top of inning number 7 here today in Barnesville. It's all Chargers. They've led it since the very beginning. I mean, literally. 5 runs in the first. They've hit 4 home runs in the ballgame. They hit 2 home runs in the first inning, 2 home runs in the 6th inning. We'll go to the top of the 7th. And leading it off, it's going to be the catcher, Will Coffin. Nobody on, just underway, top of inning number 7. Grant Edwards back out to pitch and delivers a first pitch strike. Will Coffin, the cleanup batter here for the Chargers. 2-for-4 on the day, 2 singles and an RBI. Sends this one out toward left field. Bonner will chase it back. He's on the warning track, still going back, but the ballpark will keep this one in just barely. Coffin just missed the 5th home run of the ballgame. And that's the first out here in the top of the 7th. So one down, nobody on. We're at the number 5 spot. And coming to the plate is Ryan Martin. First pitch on the way to Martin is a strike. Martin came in as a pitch hitter in the top of the 3rd after Davis Newman came out of the ballgame. Davis Newman hit a 3-run homer in the 1st. As Martin swings and misses at the 0-1 to make it nothing and 2. Gordon State has only kept Chargers off the board 1 inning today. Nasty pitch from Edwards, but Martin didn't chase. It's 1-2. 5 in the 1st, 1 in the 2nd, 4 in the 3rd, 2 in the 4th. Then nothing in the 5th. Those 2 home runs in the 6th. Swing and a miss. There's strike 3. It gets away from Thompson. Zach will find it and fire a perfect strike down the first baseline to Caleb Huffman. And that is the 2nd out of the inning. Strikeout for Edwards. 2 up, 2 down, and it's going to bring up the first baseman, Barrett Eldridge. He's been hit by a pitch the last 2 times he's come to the plate. Both times he's been hit by Edwards. On the first pitch, here comes the first one here. There's a good off-speed pitch for a strike. A walk, a ground out to 3rd, and then hit by a pitch the last 2 times up. Here's the 0-1. Fouls this one right back to the fence, and it's nothing and 2. Highlanders have not had a 1-2-3 inning today. We did hold the Chargers scoreless in the 5th, but Edwards has a chance to set them down 1-2-3 here in the 7th. Here's the stretch, the 0-2, and he'll do just that. Nasty off-speed pitch from Grant Edwards, and it's the first 1-2-3 inning of the ballgame. Grant Edwards strikes out 2 out of the 3 batters he faces. 2nd time today, Highlanders keep the Chargers off the scoreboard. That's the good news. The bad news is we've got to score some runs here in the bottom of the 7th, or it's going to be a mercy rule win for the Chargers. They're up 14-1. We're going to the bottom of inning number 7, and we'll have it for you right after this.
When it comes to printing, there's only one name to remember. Georgia Signs and Print. From banners, yard signs, magnets, life-size cutouts, and vinyl, Georgia Signs and Print is the locally owned printer there for all your printing needs. Need graphics for your company vehicles and windows? How about commercial signs and screen print? Georgia Signs and Print can handle it all. Plus, they offer the fastest turnaround time and no minimum order requirement. No job too big, no job too small. If you're looking for a local printer who offers the best customer service, highest quality, and quickest turnaround time, Georgia Signs and Print is your local printer. For more details, visit Georgia Signs and Print on Facebook. At Georgia Signs and Print, we make it our business to showcase your business. Georgia Signs and Print, proud sponsors of the K13 Media Player of the Game Award.
Here we go to the bottom of inning number 7. It's 14-1, Georgia Highlands on top. Gordon State needs 4 runs to keep the game alive. And leading it off is going to be Daniel Smith, the center fielder. Bottom of the order to lead it off. 9-1-2 coming to the plate. Michael Sharman trying to shut it down. First pitch strike. At the knees, and it's nothing and one to Smith. A fly out to right field and a strikeout in the fourth. Here's the 0-1. Fastball missed low and inside, and it's 1-1. Sharman today has given up 7 hits, 1 run. And he has been getting a lot of his outs through the air today. Been a lot of them for Gordon State, flyouts. Eleven flyouts today for the Highlanders. Here's the pitch, swing and a miss, there's strike 2. One-two count to Daniel Smith. Bottom of the 7th, nobody on, nobody out. Here's the pitch, and there's strike 3. First out of the inning, called strike. Second time today that Daniel Smith has struck out. And we'll go back to the top of the order. That's just the 4th strikeout of the ball game for Sharman. And Zach Thompson will come to the plate. First pitch is high and outside. There's ball 1. 7 hits, 4 strikeouts, just 1 walk. And he's gotten the Highlanders to fly out 11 times today. Here comes the 1-0. Foul tipped into the mitt for strike 1. Evens the count. Had a ball and a strike. Again, same 2 teams are here Saturday for a doubleheader. 1 o'clock and 4 o'clock right back here at Gordon State College. 1-1 misses outside and it's 2-1. And it looks like we're going to have an even series when we get back for Saturday. Unless we can get a huge rally here in the bottom of the 7th. Again, we've got to score 4 just to go to the top of the 8th. There's a strike on the inside corner, and it's 2-2. 10-run lead after 7 innings is the mercy rule when you play a 9-inning ball game. Yeah, the Chargers are 2 outs away from doing just that. Here's the pitch. Foul down the third base line, and Thompson stays alive. Georgia Highlands can hang on to this one. They will close in within 2 games of the lead in the conference standings. Right now they're 3 behind Gordon State. 2-2 pitch. Here it comes. Again, foul down the third baseline. Chargers sitting at 5-4 in the conference standings. They're currently tied for 2nd with Andrew College, who's 5-4. Then ABAC is 4-4. Those are your top 4 teams. The 2-2 grounded over toward third, and it's going to get in for a base hit. So Zach Thompson has his first base hit of the ball game. It comes in the bottom of the 7th, and it'll put a runner on first with 1 out. And it'll bring up the second baseman, Jackson Alford. Jackson had a single in the 1st, fly out in the 3rd, and a fly out in the 5th. Thompson with a lead at first base. Here comes the pitch to Jackson. That one's low and inside, and it's ball 1. Caleb Huffman in the on-deck circle. Here comes the 1-0, way high and outside. Michael Sharman pitching for the Chargers here in the bottom of the 7th. 2-0 count to Alford. Here's the stretch in the pitch. This one grounded to first. On the bag for one. Throw to second is going to end up in left field. And Thompson's going to be safe at second. So you're going to have a three unassisted and then an E3 on the play. As the first baseman, Barrett Eldridge, threw it out to left field, trying to get the double play. So two down, last hope for the Highlanders is Caleb Huffman. 2-for-3 on the day. He has singled his last two times to the plate. Thompson, the runner at second. First pitch on the way. This one hit over towards second. Could be the ball game. Fielded in time. Throw to first by Clay Wieson. And indeed, that is the ball game. A 4-3 put out. And it's going to be a mercy rule victory for Georgia Highlands. They are going to win it by a final of 14-1. Only the second home loss of the season for Gordon State College. Second conference loss today for the Highlanders. And again, your final, it is Georgia Highlands 14, Gordon State 1. We'll take a quick timeout, come back and give you some totals and wrap it up right after this. From Gordon State College in Barnesville.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on now at Countryside Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Jackson and Madison, and we're celebrating with huge savings on all your favorite Jeep models. Right now, save up to $10,000 on new Jeep Grand Cherokees. Take 20% off the MSRP sticker price on remaining 2023 Jeep Gladiators and get ready to go topless with our huge selection of Jeep Wranglers. Have a trade? Bring it to us. At Countryside, we accept all trades, regardless of year, make, or model. It doesn't even matter how much you owe. We'll get you out of your old ride and into a new vehicle today. Shop online, chat with our friendly staff, and apply for easy financing at CountrysideAutomotive.com. And this month, let's find your new ride at Countryside. I-75, exit 205 in Jackson, and I-20, exit 114 in Madison.
When it comes to printing, there's only one name to remember: Georgia Signs and Print. From banners, yard signs, magnets, life-size cutouts, and vinyl, Georgia Signs and Print is the locally owned printer there for all your printing needs. Need graphics for your company vehicles and windows? How about commercial signs and screen print? Georgia Signs and Print can handle it all. Plus, they offer the fastest turnaround time and no minimum order requirement. No job too big, no job too small. If you're looking for a local printer who offers the best customer service, highest quality, and quickest turnaround time, Georgia Signs and Print is your local printer. For more details, visit Georgia Signs and Print on Facebook. At Georgia Signs and Print, we make it our business to showcase your business. Georgia Signs and Print, proud sponsors of the K-13 Media Player of the Game Award.
Welcome back to Gordon State College. We've got ourselves a final here today, and unfortunately not a good one if you're a Highlander fan, as Georgia Highlands is coming to the ballpark here and beat us. And they beat us pretty doggone good here today as we welcome you back inside the Advanced Roofing and Interiors broadcast booth. I'm Chad Feltman with K-13 Media. Well, we knew there was going to be a lot of offense, or at least the potential for it, but I think we were kind of expecting both teams to have a big offensive day, especially after what we saw on Tuesday when Gordon State won 17-14. Well, today, once again, Georgia Highlands, they scored 14 for the second straight game in the series. The only problem was the Highlanders, they could only notch one today, and that was an RBI double off the bat of Dalton Bonner. So Dalton Bonner will be our Georgia Signs and Print Player of the Game. He will get the free meal to Mama's Kitchen here in Barnesville. Here are your totals for the ball game for Georgia Highlands. 14 runs on 17 hits. They had one error. Gordon State today, one run on seven hits. I did not have an error on my scorecard. Oh, yeah, I did. Sorry about that. One error. So each team with one error in the ball game. So those are your final stats from Barnesville here today. Again, 14-1, your final score. Dalton Bonner is our Georgia Science and Print Player of the Game. Right back here on Saturday, the same two teams will meet for a doubleheader. Weather's supposed to be perfect on Saturday. It's going to be sunny and somewhere around the mid-60s. Hopefully the wind will get out of town and not come back with us on Saturday, but we certainly hope you will as well. 1 o'clock and 4 o'clock game times Saturday afternoon. That's what's next for the Gordon State Highlanders. On behalf of Coach Tanner Hall and Dr. Tanya Moore, the Director of Athletics here at Gordon State College, and Dr. Don Green, the President of Gordon State College, I'm Chad Feltman with K13 Media. Hope you have yourselves a great Thursday afternoon, and come back and join the Highlanders for more baseball Saturday, a doubleheader against the Chargers right back here in Barnesville. So long, everyone. Thank you.